I get pretty nervous at a premiere just because, like, I guess I wasn't nervous at the premiere this time until my part came on. And then once, like, my part came on, I was like, oh, I am nervous. And then my heart started, like, bumping, and I started, like, getting, like, sweats. I'm like, oh, like, hope I don't blow it. And then, like, I had, like, first part, too, so, it, like, I don't know if, like, people knew how to react yet or what. And so it was kind of, like, quiet at first. I'm, like, sitting there, like, thinking, like, oh, I blew it. But, I mean, what can you do? It's, like, at the end of the day, it's, like, all you can do is hope for the best. I mean, yeah. Hopefully people like it.
Like, if there's lulls in the part, are you, like, freaking out?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm like, well, I suck. What can you do? Like, great. They gave me first part and I blew it. The hardest trick, probably the most frustrating trick, was the nollie 3 flip, because I had been there a couple times. I don't flip my board much. So when I do, it's, like, super hard and takes forever, and I just had to be patient. And so that was probably the hardest for me. No, I wasn't trying to take Chima out at all. People don't think that. I was jacked up. But no, it was actually, I flew out to SF to edit my part with Dan, and I had tried it once before and I didn't really come close. And Wolf was just like, hey, you want to go try this weekend? I was like, yeah, no, not really. And he's like, well, Brian Anderson's going to go skate. And he's like, if you want to go skate, like, we're going to go there. Either way, I'm going Saturday, so you're coming with me, because I was staying with him. I was like, all right, I'll go. And then, like, as we started editing my part the whole week, and like, things started coming together, I was still kind of, like, missing, like, a last trick that I was psyched on. So I was like, that day, like, Friday or Saturday, and I was just like, all right, I'll try and go for it. And then, like, ended up working out, and, like, Brian was, or Anderson was there, and BA's there. You got to, like, at least try. The dude's, like, legend. So that got me hyped, and then, like, there's a couple other dudes that got me hyped, so I just ended up working out. Yeah, I didn't have any knockouts. I definitely slammed a lot, probably just as much, if not more. Probably just because since I've been on, he's ripped every trip is Ray Mendetta. Just because no matter, like, what trip we've been on, like, even he doesn't have, like mood swings. Like, I feel like I'm like, oh, I'm not gonna skate. Like, I'm over it. Like, I'm just being a baby. But Ray Mendetta's like always skated every spot and never, like, he's the raddest dude if you've ever met him. Like, he's just, like, super humble, super rad. Like, talks to anybody. He's, like, got no ego, nothing. Like, he's one of the coolest dudes, and he's probably my favorite just for that, just, like, being around him and experiencing. Probably Mac now, because like, the dude went so big with him. I mean, that dude kills it. Like, he's gnarly, I don't know. Like, he's just always trying to get some, and I was like, I want to get some. I knew that I was gonna go pro, but I didn't know that they were gonna be my board at the premiere. And, like, yeah, I just, like, they were asking me, like, hey, you wanna go on stage, like, for the premiere? And I was like, nah, I was like, I don't even wanna be sitting at attention. I was like, nah, I'm off it. And then I felt bad, like, I was like, you know what, whatever, if the team's gonna go up there, I'll go up there. And then after they, like, whatever, surprised me with the board, like, they put it all, they told me, like, we didn't want the whole team, we just wanted to figure out a way to surprise you. I was like, oh, I was blowing it. Just being, like, lame dude. So, but yeah, I was super psyched to be a pro. And I mean, I don't feel like I'm, like I've said before, I don't feel like I belong in categories of, like, Mariano or Rowley or any of those dudes, but I mean, I'm definitely flattered and thankful. Pro paycheck's good enough to live somewhere, but I like this thing, it's good. Like, I don't know. Just get to go wherever I want, do whatever I want. Yeah, I just live out of this and just drive wherever I want. I like camping a lot and, like, traveling around and just going and seeing different places. So when I had an apartment once, and I always felt like myself, like, oh, I just want to go back to my apartment and hang out. And then I'd be bummed, like, dude, there's so many things I'd be doing. I'm blowing it, just, like, hanging out in my apartment being, like square. And so I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to live out of my car for a little bit, not save my money, not pay rent, not have any tie downs. And it's been, like, 6 months now, and I love it. Just, like, traveling wherever. I always try and go, like, I cross country all the time now instead of flying, or I try to. If, like, I don't have a specific time to be somewhere, so I just cross country and find, like, rad places to camp. Like, I've been to the Grand Canyon 3 times since September or so. Just camping, like, hanging out by myself, like, whatever. I don't know, it seems weird, but it's not. It's fun. but yeah, I just, like, cruise around, and, like, if I need to go somewhere, I don't really have to, like, do anything. I just, whatever, get my car and go. Like, everything I have is with me, and yeah, I don't have to get anybody to watch, like, my house or prepare to do anything. I just get up and go. It's a little weird at times. Like, I don't know. Like, people ask, like, oh, where do you stay? I'm like, you know, stay down the road. Like, it gets all awkward. Like, people in my physical therapy, they're like, yeah, so where do you stay? I'm like, I stay at Black Box. They're like, oh, they got places for you to stay? I'm like, yeah, sure.
Parking lot.
Yeah, just don't ask any more questions. No, I haven't had any special relations with the females in my car. I don't know that it would work out too well, so I'll just avoid this, that whole thing. It's not gonna work out. Lot lizards? No, I don't even know what a lot lizard is.
Those are hookers that hang out at truck stops and stuff that go around.
No, never had any run-ins with lot lizards. That's cool though. I'm glad I know what that word is now. Yeah, I have a pro shoot in the works right now with, we've been working on it actually a lot this month with Jamie and this guy Nick Pappas, who works at, he's like the dude who designs shoes at Fallen, so I've just been sitting down with him every day, like going over colors and certain things. Like basically they come up with like a general idea of what I think they think I would like, you know, and I'm just like, ixnay or yeah or whatever, like, I'm like, that's whack, and like, whatever. And like we butt heads sometimes because like, I'm like super like, I just like black and white shoes, so yeah. I'm like, they come up with colors, I'm like, yeah, I can't see myself wearing it, but all right. But I mean, it's cool, they got the best like interest for like selling, you know, most shoes, so. I'd like to work on something else, but there's not really anything too much in plan, so keep moving out of my car, skating around, that's pretty much it. All I want to do is like skate and camp, so pretty much just do that all year. Hopefully things will, something to work out. Things keep going. Booyah.
Booyah.
Give me some. Really. Oh. You see my high five in the intro to my part? Ah, I destroyed Darren Howard's hand. So okay. Good.
Pulled out James Hardy's Who's Hot from October 2006. I want to show him getting to talk about his nice little haircut here. What's going on with this hair, dude?
Dude, I was a confused little kid, alright? It was cool at the time.